Flying is bad for the environment. Carbon emissions from aviation make up more than 2% of the global total, and it's one of the fastest growing sources of greenhouse gases. All of this has put more pressure on airlines and airports to decarbonize. One option being considered is electrifying airplanes, which is easier said than done. Pound for pound, today's best batteries only store about 1/6 as much energy as jet fuel. And since planes expend energy keeping every pound of their own weight in the sky, an electric aircraft can't fly as far, as fast, or as high as one powered by jet fuel. That's where the Alice comes in. It's a 9-passenger, twin-engine plane being developed by Eviation, a startup based just north of Seattle.
Eviation is the world's first all-electric commuter aircraft manufacturer. We're making an airplane that we call Alice, designed for regional air mobility. When Alice enters into service in 2027, it's going to have an initial range of 250 nautical miles. It's going to have a typical cruising speed of 185 miles per hour. There's no emissions from Alice. There's no emissions from the electric plane. There's no tailpipe. Of course, the batteries are heavy. We have to optimize the design of the airplane around the batteries. And that's actually really what dictated the shape of the aircraft. Flying is not the enemy. Flying is our friend. It's carbon that's the problem. I'm an airplane lover above all else, and I want to make sure that we can continue to fly and travel.
Another way to make flying greener is using recycled materials for fuel. That's where Neste comes in.
Neste is an energy company. The really neat thing is the product that we make, sustainable aviation fuel. The creation of our product starts with used cooking oil primarily. And that product exists in the kitchens of many of our favorite restaurants, including Wrigley Field or airports that we use. What we're able to do is run them through conventional refineries and then return with sustainable aviation fuel. Neste currently represents 80% of the world's sustainable aviation fuel production. Some of the exciting partnerships were the airlines themselves. We found ourselves working together with American Airlines, United, Delta Airlines, JetBlue, and many others as they adopted SAF into their portfolios.
But don't get your hopes up about flying from the US to Europe with a zero carbon footprint just yet, with SAF costing 2 to 4 times as much as regular jet fuel. And the sheer weight of batteries, the greening of air travel still has a ways to go.